Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, Quantum Analyst, which focuses on quantum computing stock investing. In today's video, I am going to dig into the only quantum computing ETF in the market, ticker symbol, QTUM. I will walk you through everything you need to know about this ETF, and answer a question many investors have been wondering: is investing in a quantum ETF better than individual stocks? I will share my thoughts at the end. Stay tuned. Quantum computing has been a hot topic recently. By looking at Google Trends, we can see that web searches for quantum computing have been steadily trending up over the past 5 years. There was a spike in 2019. That was when, on October 23, 2019, Google announced that it had achieved quantum supremacy with its Sycamore quantum computer. This means that Sycamore was able to perform a calculation that would be impossible for a classical computer to perform in a reasonable amount of time. The announcement of Google's achievement was met with excitement and skepticism. Some scientists praised Google for its achievement, while others questioned the validity of the results. IBM, in particular, was critical of Google's claims, arguing that the calculation that Sycamore performed was not a true test of quantum supremacy. However, Google defended its results, and the debate is still ongoing. Many investors are enthusiastic about quantum computing and want to jump onto the bandwagon. But there are many challenges when investing in quantum computing, just to name a few. Number 1, tech complexity. The science behind quantum is highly complex. The development in quantum computing is rapid and dynamic. There are many different technological approaches, so it is hard to evaluate technology strengths, even for industry experts. Number 2, limited history. Many quantum companies are startups with limited financial track records to analyze. This makes them harder to value. Number 3, long timelines. Quantum commercialization may take 5 to 10 plus years. This requires patience for long-term holdings. Number 4, winners uncertain. It is unclear which companies will become dominant long-term players in the quantum space. Number 5, high volatility. As an emerging industry, quantum computing stocks can experience big price swings and volatility. Investors need a high tolerance for risk. Quantum hype cycles can lead to inflated expectations and stock prices. Overall, investing in quantum computing will be much harder than many people think. The potential rewards may be tempting, but the risks are substantial. Generally, if you are bullish on an industry or an investment theme, but don't know which stock or stocks to pick, a common solution is to buy an ETF. By investing in an ETF, compared to individual stocks, you get the benefits of diversification, lower volatility, and cost efficiency in some situations. Now in the North American markets, I mean the US and Canada, there are more ETFs than individual stocks. Literally, no matter what investment idea you have, there is always an ETF or a bunch of ETFs for you. In regards to quantum computing, this is also true. There is an ETF called Defiance Quantum ETF, ticker symbol, QTUM, or QTUM. According to the issuer Defiance ETFs, QTUM offers investors liquid, transparent and low-cost access to companies developing and applying quantum computing, machine learning and other transformative computing technologies. QTUM was listed on the New York Stock Exchange on September 4, 2018. According to my knowledge, it is the first quantum-themed ETF in the market and the only one as of now. Its expense ratio is 0.40%, which is relatively low compared to other thematic ETFs. As of August 14, 2023, it has $167 million in net assets. Average daily trading volume is about 40,000 shares. Average spread is 0.08%. All these numbers are quite decent, and better than most other niche thematic ETFs. In the past almost 5 years, QTUM has been in an upward trend. It is highly correlated with the NASDAQ 100 Index ETF QQQ and has outperformed the S&P 500 ETF SPY. As of the end of July, its year-to-date return is 35.6%, its total return since inception is 120%, and its annual average return since inception is 17.5%. QTUM tracks an equal-weighted index, the Blue Star Quantum Computing and Machine Learning Index. It is comprised of about 70 stocks, covering globally listed stocks across all market capitalizations. The index is reset semi-annually. It is geographically diversified. Currently, it is about 60% in North America, 20% in Europe, and 20% in Asia Pacific. Let's take a closer look at its holdings as of August 15, 2023. Out of 71 stocks in its portfolio, number 1 is RGTI, at just a little bit over 3%. Number 2 is IONQ, at just a little bit over 2%. We also see NVIDIA, Intel, NXP Semiconductors. These are semiconductor stocks. RGTI and IONQ, these two quantum computing pure players, are at the top, probably because of their recent outsized price appreciation. When checking the full holdings, we can find Google, IBM, and Honeywell. These are not quantum computing pure players, but large companies with incubated quantum computing businesses. So, should we choose the ETF or pick individual stocks? My answer is, at the current stage, I prefer individual stocks instead of the ETF, for at least two reasons. The number one reason is relevance. In the QTUM ETF, there are 71 stocks. Quantum computing pure play stocks are less than a handful. If we calculate the weighted total revenue of the total 71 stocks, we'll see that 99.99% of the total revenue is irrelevant to quantum computing. So even though the ETF's name has quantum in it, it doesn't have enough real exposure to quantum computing. It doesn't have the representation needed. Maybe in the future, this situation will change. Right now, there are more than 200 private companies and startups in the quantum computing field, many of them planning to go public in the next few years. With more and more real quantum computing stocks included in the ETF, we can get true exposure from a quantum computing ETF, and investing in an ETF will become more reasonable. The number two reason is to avoid over-diversification. Quantum computing will be one of the most important technology opportunities in the next few decades. It will grow into a trillion-dollar market, it's just a matter of time. Among all these quantum computing companies, it's very likely there will be some 10-baggers, 100-baggers, or even 1,000-baggers. Another NVIDIA is possible. Of course, the premise is that you pick the right stock or stocks and hold them for a long enough time. That concludes today's video. Please leave any comments or feedback below. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. Your support is greatly appreciated and will help me continue creating content. Thank you.